Hari Om. Hi, everyone. My name is Zach. Welcome back for more Hatha Tips. And today we'll be looking at Yoga Mudra, which is the yogic seal. And the integral yoga practice, we typically end our asana portion, the physical portion of class, with this practice. And so we'll be looking at a few components of this practice. But first, the word mudra. This is technically not an asana, which many of the physical practices are. That is, in fact, what asana means, is posture. So mudra refers to an energy seal. We're creating a certain configuration with our bodies, often with our hands. These are different forms of mudras, to encourage the energy flow of our body, the subtle energy, the prana, to move in different places. For the yoga mudra, at the end of our practice, we're using our entire body to create a shape, a geometric configuration that encourages the energy flow towards a state of equanimity and balance and harmony. We put it at the end of the practice as a means of balancing all of the effects of the practice up to that point. So whether we've been very energized or very relaxed, anything in between, this practice can help to bring us towards equanimity, towards the center. So let's take a look at it. Traditionally, it's done in a cross-legged position. It is generally recommended to have a prop to sit on. I prefer using a blanket. As long as the hips are lifted a little higher than the knees, that there is a little bit of a lumbar curve in the low back, this is what we're looking for. So if you don't need a prop, that's fine, but a prop can generally be very useful. You want this little curve in the low back and the hips higher than the knees, which are moving down. If a cross-legged position is not comfortable for you, you can come into Vajrasana, the kneeling position. This is totally acceptable. But the traditional formation is with the legs crossed. And you're also welcome to do this in a chair as well. We can take the hands behind the low back and clasp one wrist with the other hand. And it's really whatever wrist and hand combination feel comfortable for you that day. It may change day to day. Whatever works for you, left hand, right hand, whatever works for you. And the hand that is being clasped, you can use an additional mudra, chin mudra, connecting the thumb and pointer finger. That can be a nice addition to complete the circuit, close the circuit of your body's energy. You'll inhale and sit tall. And as you exhale, slowly release forward, eventually releasing the forehead to the floor. Remain here for about 30 seconds with the awareness turned inward. And after 30 seconds, slowly inhale to extend and lift the torso. As you come to a seated position, release the arms. And take a few moments to observe how you feel without rushing to the next thing. So that's the classic integral yoga form of teaching, yoga mudra. A few things to mention is that very often we find our foreheads can't reach the floor. It's a long way away, and so what are we to do? The best option really is using props to help raise the floor towards the forehead. And so a block is a tremendous option here. Pillows are a tremendous option. You can also use a stack of books if you would like. Anything to bring the floor a little closer to your forehead so that as you release forward, eventually the forehead can come there. And the idea is that you can completely relax. The arms aren't lifted. There's no stretching happening. Everything is relaxed, completely soft. So that is a very good option to have right there. And it can be as high of a stack as you would like. Another option, if the stack of blocks or other props is not working for you, perhaps you can only comfortably come a little bit forward, you can tuck the chin and release the head and shoulders and stay turned in. The idea is the awareness is moving inward towards the center. So that is another option if the stack of props is not available for you. One of the last things to mention, if this is a more comfortable practice for you, the even more traditional form of doing this practice is to sit in Padmasana, the lotus pose. So if you have Padmasana or Ardha Padmasana, the half lotus, what this does is add a different form of energetic closure, and it also provides stimulation in the digestive area from the heels coming into the digestive organs. And if you have Padmasana, you can, instead of clasping the hands behind the back, you can place fists in the heels so that as you move forward, there is this increased stimulation in the digestive area. So that is another option to mention. Again, always wanting to take time as you rise to observe how you're feeling. And the last point to make is about the time that we stay lowered in the yoga mudra position. Often there's a tendency to rush a little bit, to fold forward, take a breath, and then lift back up. But this is the kind of practice that can have very profound, noticeable energetic effects. If that's the kind of language that doesn't work for you or makes sense, or it just seems kind of weird, you don't have to worry about that. But approach the practice with a sense of curiosity, sense of investigation, and just notice for yourself. Notice what happens at the end of your practice when you take 30 seconds to fold forward, release the forehead down, release all the muscles for a good 30 seconds without rush, and slowly lift up, keeping the eyes closed and observing how you feel. Notice how that feels for you. It is a delicious cherry on top of the Hatha yoga practice. So I hope that has been helpful. Thank you very much for joining, and we will see you next time. Om Shanti.